is the inestimable benefit. And also daily endeavor ourselves to follow his blessed steps of his most holy life. Through the same thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Wisdom has built her house. She has hewn her seven pillars. She has slaughtered her animals, and she has mixed her wine. She has also set her table. She has sent out her servant girls. She calls from the highest places in the town. You that are simple, turn in here. To those without sense, she says, come, eat of my bread and drink of the wine I have mixed. Lay aside impurity and live, and walk in the way of insight. The word of the Lord.
My flesh is meat indeed, and my blood is drinking. Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory be to you, Lord.
Jesus said, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. The Jews then disputed among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? So Jesus said to them, very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Not like what your ancestors ate, and they died. But the one who eats the bread will live forever. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise be to you, O Christ.
Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. A few weeks ago, I had to go into the sacristy to retrieve my glasses. As I walked through the nave towards the sacristy, I realized the sun was setting quickly. There was only a small amount of light shining through the multicolored windows from high above. I had only a little bit of time before it would be completely dark. To make matters worse, I had forgotten to turn on the lights. After retrieving my glasses, I headed back towards the nave, which I fully expected to be dark. When I entered the nave, I was humbled. I was immediately struck by what I saw. A bright light shining over the sanctuary, illuminating the tabernacle. A bright light shining in the darkness to guide my way. The sanctuary lamp candle. A lamp that signals the real presence of Christ in the Eucharist. Not an emotional or symbolic presence, but his real presence. As I came to grips with my surroundings, I sat down into a nearby pew. No longer alone in an empty church, I was in the presence of God. I realized, as I said, we are part of a massive worldwide institution with thousands of ministries and millions of members scattered throughout the world. But none of that mattered so much as what I was gazing at, the heartbeat of our church, at its very core, illuminated by a simple flame, the Eucharist, the beating heart of the church, the beating heart that pumps Christ's blood through the members of his body, the church, providing us with the only true food, the only true drink, the precious body and blood of Jesus. An eternal map providing us a gateway to paradise and eternal life with him. Jesus' gift of himself to the Father on the cross is made present again, sacramentally, in the Eucharist. In today's Gospel, Jesus, who is never known to men's words, uses radical and alarming language to proclaim his message. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. Wow. Can you imagine hearing this for the first time? The crowd is horrified. They think that Jesus has invited them to be cannibals, eating the flesh of their fellow human beings. Because of this, we know that some of the crowd took offense and stopped following Jesus. After all, who was this so-called Jesus? God had provided them the manna that sustained them during the Exodus. However, that manna their fathers received only sustained physical life. It did not prevent them from dying. It is true, though, bread sustains life. Without it, life cannot continue. No one can argue the bread is not essential for life. So what did Jesus mean when he said, "I am the living bread"? Christ is the bread from heaven, a new bread. God has a better bread to give us, a bread which sustains us in spiritual life, not for a few years, but forever. In Christ, God gives himself to us. Here, God the Son, through the power of the Holy Spirit, offers to God the Father the perfect sacrifice of his very Son for the atonement of our sins. Christ is the bread that sustains us. When we celebrate the Eucharist, we meet God in the most intimate way. In the Eucharist, we receive a glimpse of God. Just think about it. It is a time when we're closest to Jesus. It is a time when we have the opportunity to touch and be touched by God, where our spiritual heart and conscience are connected directly to God. It is a place where truth is discovered, not invented, where we are revealed to our sorrows, where our souls are laid bare before God, where we encounter the living God. It is where the intersanctuary of our being, our soul, communicates and is touched by God. In the Eucharist, we are not merely nibbling at the bread of life. We are partaking of Jesus' body and blood, strengthening our union with him, making us heirs through hope of his everlasting kingdom. Let's face it, we all want to meet Jesus, some of us sooner than others. We want to have a closer friendship with him, to form an intimate relationship, to have Jesus more in our lives. When we come to Mass, we don't hope that Jesus will be here. His presence does not depend on our mood, attitude, or even our faith, thankfully. His presence is always here. He is always among us. The sanctuary lamp reminds us of his eternal presence. Through the Eucharist, God feeds us and nourishes us with the living bread from heaven. Jesus lives in us and makes us a living bread for the world. In the Eucharist, we deepen our relationship with Jesus. As we gaze at the sanctuary lamp, our hearts should be filled with the gratitude of what is being illuminated, the body and blood of our Savior. Jesus gave his flesh for the life of the world. He opens up paradise to all of us with the gift of his body and blood, a gift that gives immortality. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Twelfth. Lord, have mercy.
For our president, for the leaders of the nation, for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and community, for those who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the aged and the infirm, the widows and the orphans, and the sick and the suffering, for Barbara, Matthew, Jonathan, Mike, Christian, Brandon, Brad, Sherman, Mary, Kate, Sue, Ford, Ben, Lucia, Bob, Mike, Billy, Millie, Susan, Carol Sue, Nick, Dina, Lily, Kevin, Terry, Kay, Celia, Avery, Marie, Connor, Leslie, Teresa, Tammy, Michael, Linda, Carol Sue, Jim, and Ben. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor and the oppressed, for the unemployed and destitute, for prisoners and captives, and for all who are in care for them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have called, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
In the communion of Blessed Mary and Virgin, the holy patriarchs, the prophets, the apostles, and the martyrs, and all the saints, let us commend ourselves to one another and all our life to Christ our Father.
To thee, O Lord, our God.
Thine is the majesty, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever, and unto the ages. Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Maker of all things, that is all men, we acknowledge and pray our manifold sins and weaknesses, which we from time to time have seriously have committed by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine mercy. Provoking most justly our wrath and indignation against us, we earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdemeanors. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. Let thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, say, give us all those past, and grant that we may ever be after, serve, and lead to the unity of life, the honor and glory of the Almighty. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of His great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins, to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto Him. Have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray.
The angel of the Lord tread upon the mouth of the king, and till it ever hath done. For it is the seed of gracious the Lord is.
Thank you.
holy sacrifices offered to the glory of God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost in Blessed Trinity, with special intention of prayer for the needs and concerns of this congregation. The sanctuary lamp candle is given to the glory of God in loving memory of Lucille Gale Wingfield. The altar flowers are given to the glory of God in thanksgiving for Kate Traylor for her 14th birthday. The music is given to the glory of God and in thanksgiving for Lindsay Finn. Pray, brethren, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable unto God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord receive the sacrifice of thy hands. Praise the glory of his name, both of our life and that of all his holy church.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God.
It is indeed right and deserved to do.
It is very deep right in our bountiful duties that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God, Creator of the life, source of life, who has made us in thine image and called us a new life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Thy dear beloved Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, who Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant by the merits of death of thy Son Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sin and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee. Humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and make one body with him, that we may dwell, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, in all honor and glory, world without end.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst enter under my roof, but speak your word only, and my soul shall be healed.
wonderful and exciting blessing to come right now. I would like to have all of the students come forward, and also to have those teachers that are here from anywhere, everywhere, to come, also come forward, and then those that have come bearing gifts to come on to the front here at the bottom of the stage. This is just a wonderful thing. Teachers from here and there, students of all ages, it looks, and then the tools that they will need to work with. What I will do, we can stay right where we are, as we are. I will bless and cover generally. The holy water. And I'll start by a prayer for teachers. Or perhaps I'll change that. And I'll have a start with the students. And then we'll go that direction. All right, here we are. Oh Lord, bless these backpacks and the children in you who carry them as they begin another year of school. Give them peace when they feel nervous, focus when they feel distracted, energy when they feel tired. Open their minds to the lessons they will learn both in and outside the classroom. Help them to make friends that build one another up and be friends to those who need them. Guide them in making good choices as they grow in wisdom and maturity. Be ever present with them in the classroom, on the school bus, on the playground, and at home. And may they feel your loving care in all that they do. Amen.
Amen.
For the teachers, Almighty God, bless those in the ministry of teaching future generations as they embark in a new school year. Grant them energy, passion, discipline, and endurance for their daily tasks. Fill their classrooms with an atmosphere of care and mutual respect, that all interactions will be absorbed in patience and understanding. Help their lessons to grow pupils in both knowledge and character, and help us all to support the work these teachers do, building up our community and our future. Amen. Amen. For those who donated backpacks and other supplies, Lord, bless these backpacks and school supplies, and the children who will use them Let these physical gifts be symbols of the life, the love and life we support to give these children in our community throughout the year. Help us to look upon every child in our community as one of our own, helping them to grow in character and knowledge. We pray all these things in the holy name of Jesus.
Amen.
Bless these backpacks given for this community. May God love you and keep you all.
Serve the Lord.
Amen.